give you guys a little couple of updates. Don't forget the Forbidden Knowledge, the contest for the Forbidden Crown. It ends in a couple of days on December the 10th. That's only a few days away. December the 10th. There's a lot of great entries if you go to Forbidden Giveaways. Forbidden Giveaways on Instagram. That Instagram account is dedicated to all the things that I give away. Right now, we're posting all the people that have entered this contest over there as well. There's some really, really funny ones there. We'll be picking up the top three, and we'll put them on this account and let the fans pick who the winner is, okay? December the 10th, it'll be $1,000 cash, and that'll be paid via either Cash App, Venmo, or PayPal on December the 10th. Just a few more days, guys. And so what you have to do is, let me see, you have to get your filter on. You have to go to a reel, make a reel, get the filter, and then, boom, you put on a crown. This is a crown, right? You can change the color. You could put blue, black, white, red, green, whatever color you want. Okay, and of course, imitate me, Forbidden Knowledge. And you do tag at Forbidden Giveaways, tag at Forbidden Knowledge, and of course, hashtag Forbidden Crown. And with your best imitation, we will get that and we will repost it up on that account. Some of them I repost on this account. A couple more I'm going to probably put up tonight because they're just too funny. Also, there's a couple modifications of the filter. We have, this is a Forbidden Crown filter. We now have the Forbidden Disguise. So the Forbidden Disguise, I'll take my glasses off, will give you the Forbidden Glasses, give you my beard. This is crazy. And my hat. Okay? This is too funny. This is crazy. Anyway, so you guys can put on the Forbidden Disguise and, you know, imitate me. Same thing. What's up, Mike? And you can do it that way, right? So you got the Forbidden Disguise. And what's cool about this Forbidden Disguise, it will actually let you change up the beard and the glasses and the hat. You can switch it out and stuff like that. It's kind of funny. All right. This is some funny stuff. All right. So, and then you also, I don't know if you knew this, but I haven't done this contest yet, but soon I'm going to do the Forbidden Thoth giveaway. So this is, you know, Thoth from my book, Compendium of the Emerald Tablets, the Egyptian priest king. All right. And if I want, I can raise my hand and send out some positive energy to you. All right. That's from the cover of my book. You gotta love it. Look at the detail work on the garment over my head. Pretty cool stuff, right? And you can raise your hand and send out positive vibrations. All right. So pretty cool stuff. All right. So yeah, we got all those options there for you. Have some fun, guys. Gotta have some fun. If you're out here being too serious 24/7, it ain't, you know, come on, it ain't even worth it. Every now and then you gotta have some fun. And so what can we do for fun? These kind of little things, man. Harmless fun that's not gonna hurt anyone. It's gonna make people laugh, things like that, you know? So anyway, you might wake up and not want to comb your hair, right? Your hair might be all messed up. Man or woman, you might be like, you know what? Let me cover my head. You gotta get online right quick. And I don't wanna show my head. All right, so, but anyway, those crowns are up there. Now this Forbidden Crown, Copper Child Mike L is the inventor of this crown. He's making a custom line also, which is going to be pretty cool. All right. And we'll have more coming about that very soon. But the beautiful thing is, you know, you can use these filters and you can actually, you know, do the imitation. You might win $1,000. Or you can just use them just for fun. I see people posting them all the time now when they're doing lives with other people, just for fun. So it's all good. It's cool. Something fun to do. Harmless, clean fun. All right. So don't forget, December the 10th. That's when that thing ends. So Forbidden Giveaways. Let me put it down here in this comment box. Okay. At Forbidden giveaways. I'm gonna put it here and actually put it in the comment box and save it here. Pinned comment. Okay, there you go. I just pinned the comment. Forbidden giveaways. That's what you want to follow. That's the account that I'm putting all my giveaways. And I'm going to start going back now to all the stuff that I gave away and start loading it up over there. Okay. The people who I gave all those MacBook Pros to and the laptops and the car, and all that stuff that I've been giving away, I'm putting the people, the cartouches that I was in Egypt, I'm putting all that stuff on forbidden giveaways for fidelity's sake. So I'm going to start digging through my past history, my thank you notes and all this kind of stuff, emails or whatever, and start loading all the people that I've given stuff away to over there. The people I gave the $1,000 grants to during the whole lockdown, all that stuff. So I'm putting them over on forbidden giveaways, okay, for fidelity's sake. Now, thank you to everyone that gave for the inmate book drive, and thank you to everyone that registered inmates to receive books. We sent out all the books. All the books have now been sent and shipped, gone, okay? And so the books were mailed out. I paid for all the shipping on all those books. It came to around $1,500. I paid that today. And I have the receipts, as they say, as they say in the hood. I got the receipts. And so I'll be posting those receipts from Pac Mail over on Forbidden Giveaway. So when you guys do the badge money, some of that badge money that's coming in, that helped pay for some of the shipping for the inmate. So if you didn't register an inmate to get a book, and if you didn't donate a book, but you gave a badge, well, you still participated, because some of that badge money, whenever it hits my account, could be a month from now. That, you could say, that's got been credited towards helping me pay for the shipping for a lot of these books to go out to the inmates. All right. So a lot of people are going to be happy. These inmates are going to be happy when these books arrive in their mailbox at these correctional facilities in just a few days' time. I shipped everything. I didn't do any media mail shipments, which would take forever, and just because it's cheaper. I shipped everything either first class or priority, depending on if the price was virtually the same. So everybody was shipped first class or priority, and we have tracking numbers for every single one. So if you did fill out a form for an inmate to receive a book and they don't get a book within a week from now, we do have a tracking number. We can see what happened, where it's at, and so forth and so on. So we have all the tracking numbers. So you can always email customer service at forbiddenknowledge.com. You know, but give it about a week, week and a half, because we know it's holiday season. Give them a chance to get that book, all right? Next stage of business, you saw me post a meme earlier, right? I posted a meme about what I gave my kids for Christmas, for the holidays. I really don't celebrate Christmas, for the holidays. And it's that I gave them stocks. And I saw some comments, because I posted that meme on a few of my accounts around between Facebook, Instagram, Unite the 99, and so forth and so on. And I saw some people commenting on the, a lot of positive, 99.9% positive. Some people like, yeah, right. Some people were like, yeah, only you can afford the stocks. We can't afford the stocks. So congratulations, you know, sarcastically. Let me tell you something. There's stocks out there that cost a dollar. There's stocks out there that cost $14. One of the top stocks on my list, my buy list right now, is only $14. There's stocks out there that you can get for, you know, $30, $40. So you look at Plug, PLUG. I started telling people to buy Plug when it was only $29. Then when I did my stock options trading class, Plug had moved up to around 40 or 39 or 40. Now Plug's at about between 40. It's averaging between right now $44 and $47 a share. Okay? So you mean to tell me you can't afford to buy your kid one share of Plug for 40 bucks? Is that what you're trying to tell me? When you're going to buy the Jordans and the outfits and all this other crazy stuff? You can't afford to buy your kid one share of something that costs $30, $40? Come on. You know, yeah. I bought my kids all shares, fractions of shares of Tesla. Okay, that's what I did. So stockpile.com is the only place that you can get, that I know of, that you can buy stock gift certificates. Stockpile.com. And Stockpile also will let your kids buy stocks and so they can save money with the parental approval. I love it. It's huge. Stockpile.com. When I told my kids aren't my kids aren't babies anymore, you know. My oldest kid is 21, going to be 22 in a few months. And my oldest kid is right now 31, okay? But anyway, when I gave my kids these stocks, at least the two that have, you know, already received them, because all my kids aren't in the same state, but they were excited. They were happy. They were like, wow. Okay. My son happened to be by, because my son works for me. My son, Justin Carson, he works for me. And he was by because he came to pick up those books to take to pack mail, all the inmate books that were donated. I said, I'm going to give it to you now. Because it don't matter what day, you know, I'm, you know, the 25th, whatever. I gave it to him now. Why I give it to him now? Because Tesla is going to split soon. I don't want Tesla to split before he installs a stock into his account. So I said, sign up for your free account, claim this gift certificate of stock now, and get it in your account now today, so that in case Tesla splits in a few days, you get in on the split before the stock splits. Okay, when the stock splits, you have X amount of extra shares on the house. So get it now, because all of a sudden, if it splits, boom, you can have five times the amount of shares just as in that instant. You know, it's rumored to split soon. It might be this month, it might be next month, but it's rumored to split soon, right? It's supposed to be a five-way split. And so if you have 100 shares, which I have 100 shares, that means I now have 500 shares. Now the price of the shares drops when it splits, but then the value slowly creeps right back up to where it was, and sometimes, in most cases, surpasses where it was. So that 100 shares is going to be $1 million for me in 5 years. You see, we got to learn. We got to get the financial literacy. We got to take away all this ignorance and stop. You know, somebody said, which one? Tesla. We got to learn how to play with this, because I guarantee you, the wealthy people, they play chess, not checkers. And a lot of us out here are playing checkers, okay? And I saw some of those comments. I was like, are you kidding me? I wish somebody would have bought me a share of Microsoft. I remember when I got my son his first stock traded account, my youngest son, Justin, because I've been teaching him how to trade options now for like 3 years. So he started when he was a teenager, all right? Built his own account up, making a lot of money on his own now. He don't even need me no more. I remember the first stock that he got was when you sign up through my link for that particular brokerage account, they gave away one free stock, and his free stock was Microsoft. And he got it when it was $99. And now I believe it's $314 or $315, I'm rough estimate, but it's sitting at 314, 15, 320, somewhere in that range right now, right? Now, that's a great gift to give somebody, a gift that grows. You give somebody something when it's less than $100 and in just 3 short years, it's worth $300. What's wrong with that? That's better than the bank savings account. If you put money in your credit union or your bank savings account, my daughter put $10,000 in her savings account. My daughter, April Carson, she put $10,000 in her savings account. She got into a car accident a few years back, and she won $10,000 from the accident and put it in a savings account, and she had it in there for a couple years. I called her. This is a while back now, about a year ago maybe. And I said, hey, what's up, babe? How you doing? She said, oh, what's up, Dad? I said, how much money has the bank paid you for that savings account? She was like, what do you mean? I said, has the bank paid you any money for that money that you told me you were putting in savings? She says, well, no, they didn't pay me any money. I said, well, that's a shame, because they're using your money every single day in investments. And they're making a lot of money on your money, and they're making a lot of money lending out your money every single day. She says, oh, man. I said, yeah. So I told her what to do. And so she diversified the savings account, some into crypto, some into stocks. And now that $10,000 in just a year, a little over a year later, is almost $22,000. You see? So your money has to work for you. Your money should be your employees. Every dollar should be an employee. And there's nothing wrong with cracking the whip on the employees that are in the form of bills, paper. Conscious energy is all it really is. Energy exchange. Put them to work. Put that energy to work. Money is just an energy exchange. Put that money to work. Let it bring back benefits to you. And so, and scared money don't make any money either. You got to remember that. So you got to be willing to risk some to gain some. Overall, with the right decisions and the right, making the right moves by doing a little bit of research. And the research is out there everywhere for this game. This is the oldest game in the book. All right. A guy I know became a billionaire purely off the stock market. Okay. Purely off the stock. Now he owns shopping malls. He owns rental, apartment communities, all luxury apartment communities all over the country. Now he makes $20 million a month on one mall that he bought. He bought one mall, one shopping mall. It's a huge mall in Sunrise. It's the Sawgrass Mall. But he makes, after all the bills are paid and everything else, his net is 20M. Came up off the stock market, guys. Came up off the stock market. So, you gotta understand the game out here. We gotta stop pretending like it's cool to be broke, you know? We got to be buying assets. We have to be buying assets. Earn your leisure. Those guys have a pretty cool statement. Assets over liabilities. Assets over liabilities. That's their quote, not mine. It's a pretty cool quote because it really makes a lot of sense. And sometimes people see me with flashy things, like I might have a very expensive watch on, but I buy investment watches. I don't buy watches that have no that don't hold their value, or watches that the value disappears over time. I buy watches that actually appreciate in time. So I have investment watches. Okay. Rolex right now is one of the greatest investment watches that ever did it. There's a shortage of Rolex watches now. If you go to the store to order a new Rolex at the Rolex dealer, it's going to take you 44 months on the waiting list before you might be able to get delivery of that watch. Now you can buy one from one of these quote unquote, salespeople that are not really a Rolex dealer. You can buy one from eBay and this and that. You don't really know what you're getting sometimes. Some of the parts could be switched out and swapped out or whatever. But if you want an authentic Rolex at MSRP, retail price, without having to pay 20, 30, 40, 50,000 over, you can get one from Rolex. You just gotta wait a year or two. I know that the sports models are all 2 year waits, and that doesn't guarantee that you'll be able to get it. That's how the shortage is. So if you're able to get your hands on some really good deals, some really good dealers that have the watch, you can get a. I bought a Rolex Batman for 15,000. It's already worth 22,000 now. I bought a Rolex Hulk, which is a beautiful watch. That watch, initially, you can get it for 10,000 directly from Rolex if you want to wait a couple years. If you find the right dealer, I have a really good watch dealer. You can get away with getting it for about between 17 and 18,000. If you really got a person that's really not trying to make too much money on top of the watch, because these resellers are usually selling in that 20, 20,000 range. You can get that now for between $25,000 and $30,000. So I gave somebody a Rolex watch as a gift last year. The watch is already worth $7,000 more than when it was purchased. So it's an investment watch. Richard Mille is an investment watch. They're limited editions. Only a few are made every single year. So if you get one of those, within just a short period of time, the accrued value just builds up very fast. So I buy investment watches. Okay. Then I have a big house. People say, this guy's living in this big old house all by himself. He's just showing off, and homeless people can have a place to stay. I've seen all the comments. Well, this house is like my empire. So I'm standing in an office space right now in the house, right? Then I have, of course, you have to have a dining room because I do a lot of entertaining for my chef comes over. The family room area is a great area to read in, overlooking the water. Then I have another room that can be converted into another studio room where I can sit in a high chair and I can actually read my teleprompter and record myself over there. I have another room that gives me the ability to clear my mind and do my meditation and get my thoughts proper, get my thoughts right. And then you have to have a few guest bedrooms, right? And so I don't waste any space. All the space is actually used here. I have a gym in the house in another room. I converted another bedroom into a gym so that I can actually go and work out somewhere where I have to worry about getting up and rolling out of the house in case another one of these crazy variants come out. See? And then there's construction going on right behind my house. New construction. This is new construction, but that's newer construction. So as those houses are being built, the equity in this house goes up every single day. When those houses are complete, this house has $150,000 built-in equity that I can dump the equity and sell the house and move. I can get a HELOC and get equity out of my house and use it for business, use it for investments, whatever I want. If I want to buy 3 Bitcoins or something in one day, I might wake up and go, you know what? Let me take the equity and buy 3 Bitcoins. It'll make me even more right there. Or whatever. I might see a property I want to flip. I'd be like, let me grab a HELOC equity out of my house. Let me buy this house for $70,000. Let me spend another $20,000 fixing it. And then boom, let me flip it. And within 2 months, 60 days max, usually flip it. And then make some money on the flip of a rehab house. So I can actually leverage the equity in this house to do those kind of things, right? Then I have 4 cars. And people go, oh man, that's too materialistic. Why do you got 4 cars? Even one of my neighbors is like, welcome to the neighborhood. We can't wait to meet your family. I said, well, you met them. It's me. As of right now, eventually I might have somebody in here, but right now it's just me. This is the fact. Well, you have more than 1 car. I said, well, you're lucky. I usually have 5. But why do I have 5 cars? It's not to show off. Those cars make me money. At any given moment, if everything stopped working properly in any of the other businesses, I got 4 cars that can go out there and make me 30 grand a month every single month. Right now, today, right now. Right now. They're workers. Those cars are employees. They work for me. They work for me, not against me. First of all, those cars are in my company name, so they're business cars, number one. They're not personal use cars, they're corporate cars, right? They're corporate leases. And with a lease, you can write off 100% of your auto lease payment on your taxes versus buying a car, you only get a percentage of the depreciated value. This is why rich people drive cars that are expensive. We don't pay any money for them. We drive for free, guys. We drive for free. It didn't cost any money. Then you take those same cars and you rent them out. Now, I have a driver, a permanent driver that I use, but I don't drive everywhere every 5 minutes. So he has time for other clients. And so instead of him going and renting somebody else's cars to drive them, he just uses mine. Worked out a great deal with them. Right now, my Escalade, my 2021 Escalade is not in my driveway. Why? It's been gone for Art Basel in Miami. It's been Art Baseling all week long. Week and a half now, Art Baseling. Back and forth, celebrities and actors and rappers and everything else. And he just called me yesterday. He says, okay, Mr. Carson, I got this many hours, this many trips, or whatever. This is what the payment was. And I'll be bringing you your $10,000. Do you want me to keep the truck a little bit longer or do you want me to bring it back? I said, keep that thing on the road, puppy. I want that thing out there right now. You make as much as you can while all these famous people are in town right now. Because the rates go up, premium rates right now. right? 10 grand, this car's made me. The other day he clocked 21 hours. Now, he does get a chance to rest because a lot of those hours are him just sitting in the car waiting for the client to come back out. Sometimes the client goes in a hotel and goes to sleep. He takes a nap. You know, that's the kind of job he actually likes, this job. This is what he's kind of really born to do. All right, I've been using him for years. And so he gets a chance to get little power naps and such in. But yeah, it's good money. And there's other people out there that work along with him. Sometimes I use two drivers at once. Like my friend came in town, a billionaire, is a good friend of mine. The only billionaire that I can really call on the phone, and he'll pick up the phone and answer me. And me and him share knowledge back and forth. He teaches me financial knowledge and I give him esoteric wisdom. That's our energy exchange. He says, look, I got a new girlfriend. We're flying into town because he lives in three different states. We'll fly in. She wants to go to a fancy restaurant in Miami. So I called my driver and said, Junior, I need you to get me another driver. One of the other guys that we've used before, because I want to take two cars, because I want to give Bill his own experience in the Rolls Royce Ghost, and you'll take me and my girl in the S class, and so we'll go and we'll both go down to Miami. Okay, so if I got somebody that I'm giving a special VIP treatment, I'm not going to be up in the car with them. But these cars are workhorses; they'll go out there and make me money. The Ghost, at any given time, if everything is going wrong and everything is going south, I can put that Ghost on the road today for $900 a day. And in the premium time like this, it'll be $1,050 per day. Per day. So where people see materialism and cars, I see a smart entrepreneur that knows how to keep money in his pocket and his bills paid. And the legacy being built. You see? Some people start judging immediately without knowing the situation. When I see people when I see a rich person driving a Range Rover, which Billy, he's a billionaire. He drives a Range Rover. My friend Billy, he drives a Range Rover. Why do all these rich people drive Range Rovers? Why? Does it look good? I mean, yeah, the car looks pretty good. Okay. Electronic package wise, it's okay. I've seen better. But the car, the weight of the car weighs over 4,500 pounds. So they get passenger, they get, credit for the car weight. In other words, not just a personal use car, it's in their business name. And it's also a car that's used for transportation, a transportation vehicle for multiple people. And that weight gives you another 15,000 tax credit. So not only do you get the 100% credit for the lease payments, but then you get another 15K back for the weight of the car on top of that, plus the miles and gas, by the way, and tires and everything else. That's why they drive the Range Rovers. Because the car is free and it pays you money to drive it. You get paid to drive the car. That's why they drive the Range Rovers. That's why I have the Ghost. This is my fourth Ghost that I have. Why do I drive the Ghost? Because of the weight of the car. It's a business lease that gives me all my money back. I can rent it out and make a profit, and I get another 15 grand because of the weight of the vehicle. It is financial literacy, knowing how to play this financial matrix, guys. That's why I wrote the book. Woke doesn't mean broke. That's why I wrote that book. That book is still a bestseller. Woke doesn't mean broke. If you don't know about that book, you need to go on Amazon. Go to my website, Forbidden Knowledge. Get the book, guys. It's 688 pages. The book is serious. Where's that book at? Let me see if I have a copy down here. Maybe I don't. I got all these books down here except for that one. The rest of that book must be upstairs. But yeah, down here alone is about 400 books. But I'll have one. I'll post one. Maybe I'll tag that book. When I post this to Instagram, this live, and save it on Instagram, I'll tag the book. Woke doesn't mean broke. Guys, you have to learn how to bend this financial matrix to your will. Literally. And here we go. Here goes one here. Look at this guy. Shilling. whoever this guy name is, Steve Otio. Yeah, another one of these people, another one of these bums out here on the internet. There's so many bums on the internet. There's like so many bums out here. This conscious community is like poison in a way. You got people that really want to seek consciousness, really want to learn more. But as soon as you start talking about how to make money, how to be wealthy, and how to transcend this broke mentality, they get angry and frustrated. You know why this bum just got angry and frustrated on my live? He got angry and frustrated because of his own inadequacies, his lack of his ability to take care of himself properly, his family properly, to his lack of his ability to build a legacy. It's not even his lack of his ability. It's probably most likely his inability and his laziness and procrastination that has put him in a position, in a mental state where all he can see is envy, and all he becomes is envious and jealous. And so when he sees somebody talking about financial tricks and financial hacks and how to become better with managing your money and manipulate things to get yourself what you need, he sees it as, I'm a pocket watcher and this guy's making it hard for me, because if my wife sees this, if my girlfriend sees what this guy's talking about, she's going to bug the crap out of me and I'm going to have to get off my lazy ass and do something out here. That's what these bums do, man. These broke hoteps. You got to watch out for these broke ass hoteps out here on these streets. All they want to do is do the lullaby talk to you, but they can't provide nothing. They can't take care of you, your family. They can't take care of themselves. They all riding bicycles. They got nothing out here. They're bums. That guy was a bum. I didn't even block him from my life because I want him to hear me call him an absolute bum. He's a lazy bum. When these people start hearing you talk about helping people become better, there's people on this live right now that heard what I just said about these several topics, and they're going to actually utilize the knowledge, you see? Because knowledge is not power. That statement is wrong. The application of knowledge is power. Some people on this live today heard what I said, and they're going to come up, and their family is going to come up. Future generations are going to come up. But these bums that are out here on this internet, these bums that run around trolling on people and talking garbage and making up lies and posting garbage all over the place, these bums ain't going to do nothing, man. You look at them in 10 years, 20 years, they're in the same spot or worse than where they were. That guy's probably on a prepaid track phone in robes and slippers, you know, because he's too lazy to go out and do something with himself. You know, that's what it is. These are too many bums out here. And these women are getting hip to these bums too, ain't y'all? Y'all are getting smart. I see these women out here. They're like, you know what? These guys are bums, man. I need to get with somebody who got knowledge. I see that knowledge is the new sexy now. Knowledge is the new sexy, man. We're looking good out here. The brothers with the knowledge and the, I don't care what race you are. If you got knowledge, you're the new sexy. If you know how to operate and navigate this financial matrix and provide security and stability, you're the new sexy. Literally, you're the new sexy. This broke stuff and I'm working at the warehouse and I can't pay my light bill and all that, that ain't sexy no more. I don't care how, I don't care about all, what else you can provide. You can't provide stability and security, you ain't sexy no more. They starting to see through that foolishness. A couple of romps in the sack, and after that, it's over. You don't have anything long-term. You can't provide long-term, man. You can't do a damn thing for nobody. You can barely take care of yourself. And these same guys, I see them, these broke hoteps, they run around. Yeah, they try to use all the words, you know, the conscious phrases to hook the women. And they'll lure some of these women in with that talk, you know, right? They'll lure them in. And then what happens? The women start to see through it. Wait a minute. Okay. You living in mama's basement? Wait a minute. You can't, your car got repossessed. Oh, wait a minute. You asking me to help go half and half on the dinner tonight? Oh yeah, this ain't going to work out. And it has nothing to do with the woman being a gold digger. It has to do with, hey, if we become partners long-term, Are you providing any stability and security for me? Or are you just another one of these bums that just wants to have sex and run away? That's the reality of it. That's the reality of it. And these women are starting to see, they're finally waking up. These women are finally waking up and starting to see through this garbage that's going on out here on these streets. You see, men had it good for a long time because why? Because women outnumber men because of all the religious wars. So all these religious wars that have happened and now all the oil wars that have happened in modern times, but we are now, it's now 4-1. In some cases, really, depending on how you evaluate, it could be 5-1. 5 women to 1 man or 4 women to 1 man on earth. So they outnumber us. And so because women outnumber us, it makes it easy for a dude. Like, it's easy to go find a woman. I don't care how you look. I don't care what shape you're in. I don't care if you never worked out a day in your life, you got a big old belly hanging over the front of your pants. It don't matter. Because I tell you what, if you go door to door, knocking on door to door and say, hey, would you like to go on a date? Hey, would you like to go on a date? Eventually, some woman's going to say, yeah, let's go. There's a shortage of men out here. And then, of course, you know, you have the alternative crowd. So there's even more of a shortage of heterosexual men. That number's adding to it right now as well. Right, that percentage from the alternative crowd. So it's a shortage of men out here. So women have been putting up with a lot of garbage from men for a while. A lot of garbage. But now they're going, you know what? I'm not going to settle for this anymore. They're like, I'm not settling for this broke mentality anymore. This dumb mentality. This lack of stability. Lack of confidence. You know, I'm not settling. Women aren't settling for that anymore, man. They want a guy that can provide stability, that they can feel safe with. That's another thing. You got to be a real man's man out here on these streets. I'm packing 24/7, concealed weapons, baby. If anybody come at my family sideways, they're going to be back in the reincarnation cycle in the blink of an eye. I'm going to put you back in the reincarnation cycle, and then I'm going to go to sleep. And I'm gonna sleep like a baby. Okay? They want stability, they want security and safety, and they want somebody with knowledge. Somebody that can add to them and teach them things. Not that you won't learn from her, because you gotta learn from her as well, but at the same time, they want somebody that has a little something going on up here, other than let's get in the sack. That sack game is wearing off now. You hop in the sack. Now they starting to use us for that sack. They're like, oh, yeah, I'll use them for the sack. He think I'm interested. I just want to hop in a sack for one quick minute, and I'm done with this bum. Y'all don't know the game out here, man. Y'all think y'all know the game, but y'all don't really know what's going on, a lot of y'all. But anyway, I digress. Let me get back into the topics at hand. We have the Forbidden Tour of Egypt coming up. Going to be amazing, amazing. Somebody said you broke my Insta app. Gonna have an amazing tour of Egypt. Okay, that's coming up October of 2022, but you gotta register soon. Their tour is for 50 people. However, that is a little bit off because I'm taking 50 people with me, but 10 of those people are my crew. Okay, so it's really 40 people because we have the camera crew, we have armed guards, which you need. We need that. Not that it's that dangerous, but when I have that many people rolling, I don't want any enterprising people from the region saying, you know what, let's do something here. So we have armed guards, we have the camera crew, we have the Egyptologist, we have the licensed guide that helps us with all the VIP access and getting us through security and the military and the police and everything else we got to do. And we have Elizabeth Hoekstra, who's my director of operations. So by the time you add all that up, and we have Regina Meredith. So by the time you add all of that up, there's pretty much, 10 seats are gone. Right. So we only have really 40. It's not really 50. It's 40. And so since people have already been reserving their space, that's dropping down every single day. So you want to go to forbiddenknowledge.com, click on Forbidden Tour of Egypt and register for that trip. It's October of 2022, but we're going to close registrations, I believe, in the beginning of April. And all funds must be due by then. You can pay off installments or whatever. There's all kind of ways to do it. But by April, we have to close it because we have to take a percentage of that money and prepay for the licensing, the military fees, the police fees, the private access that we have to everything that's going on. The bus and all that has to be pre-reserved months in advance, so we won't have it. All right. So go to forbiddenknowledge.com. Click on Forbidden Tour of Egypt. It's going to be an amazing trip. We're going to meditate in a hidden chamber underneath the Great Pyramid. Nobody gets to do that. We'll have private access to the Great Pyramid. Private access meaning it's VIP status. Nobody, no tourists. Nobody will be able to come and interact, intersect, go ahead of us, be in there with us at the same moment and all that kind of stuff. We lock down the whole Giza Plateau. We own it. We're going to do a special meditation inside the Grand Gallery, going up the Grand Gallery into the King's Chamber and do a special meditation in the King's Chamber of the Great Pyramid. I'm going to show you some hidden carvings that are in the solid granite in the Great Pyramid that hardly anyone even knew existed, including Egyptologists. And I did a whole workshop on this with Robert Grant. It's going to blow people away when they finally see what's really there that's been hidden for all these thousands of years, hidden in plain sight. You're going to see that. We're going to have private access to the Sphinx enclosure. You'll be able to walk between the Sphinx's paws and touch the Dream Stellar. Nobody gets to do that. Nobody. It's going to be amazing. And then we have private access to Dendera, to some of the hidden crypts that are there that very few have been released to the general public. We get access to all 13 of them. I don't know if we'll do all 13 in one day, but we'll definitely get a chance to do quite a bit of them. And you'll be able to take photos and pictures and video and everything else. Plus, we're doing it with a camera crew so we can document everything. And it'll be all on Forbidden TV. And you'll be in the show. You'll have to sign a release, video release, but you'll be in the TV show from this actual trip. There's just so much. We're doing a 3-day Nile cruise on the Sonesta St. George. That's a 5-star ship that sails down the Nile. I've been on it twice now. It's 5-star. It's incredible 5-star chef food. It's just incredible. And we get to stop along the way in Thebes, and we stop in, Karnak and Luxor along the way, right? We're going to drive through the desert for 4 hours to get to Abu Simbel and go see Ramses' temple and also the temple he built right next to it for his beautiful wife. And it's just going to be an amazing trip. I'm looking forward to this trip. And, but you got to register ASAP on ForbiddenKnowledge.com to go on this trip, all right? All the food is included for when we're out in the field. Airlines are included in all the flights that are in Egypt are included. So while we're there, we'll have to fly a couple times. That's going to be included. The flights while in country are included, right? Your visas and all that stuff, we'll take care of the VIP service for that. And the hotels are all included. They're all 5-star hotels. 5-star. I don't sleep in anything less than 5. That's the level I'm at. If it's not 5, I don't mess with it. So 5-star hotels included. You have to fly there on your own and fly back to your house on your own. That's it. So when you get there, you'll be greeted with a person with a sign with your name on it. And from there, it's VIP service all the way. You're never going to get lost or misguided. All right. It's going to be an amazing tour. I'm looking forward to that tour. It's going to be incredible. And next week, my whatchamacallit comes out. My series, Ancient Connections. My new series, Ancient Connections. First episode airs next week. You're going to love that. And don't forget about the Forbidden Knowledge Podcast Network, which is on my YouTube account. We have several different podcasters up there along with myself. And putting a lot of great content every single week. All right, every single week. So you're gonna love it. It's gonna be amazing. All right. What a narrow mind to say I only sleep 5-star. That's not a narrow mind. That's an expanded mind. Who said this? Who said this foolishness? You got another person talking some garbage here. Listen to me, CKZ, whatever your name is. A mind one stretch can never go back. I slept in the gutter. I was homeless one time. I slept on the beach for 1 week. I know what it feels like to have nothing. I know what it feels like to walk around with holes in your shoes. I know what it feels like to walk around to not have underwear on because you're growing so fast, the underwear don't fit. It's squeezing your doggone ball sack so hard, you can't even breathe. So you gotta go around with no underwear on. I know what that feels like. I know what it feels like to sleep in a house that has roaches and bugs. And when I was doing my travel teams, I know what it feels like to have to find the cheaper hotels. And sometimes there's bugs and roaches and the beds. You know that this bed is full of all kind of semen and everything else. I'm not putting myself in I'm 50 years old. I'm not putting myself in them kind of situations ever again. Just like I made a promise to myself I was never going to go around with old sneakers and holes in my shoes ever again. I'm not going to be living in no house with no damn roaches ever again and a broken doggone sink. We didn't even have a septic tank. When I was a kid, our septic tank broke. And so you have to take showers in buckets. And every time you wash the dishes, you have to wash dishes in buckets and take the buckets and dump them way in the backyard because it started to stink after a while. Then when I got a little older, I had to go to some hotels for traveling and sports and stuff. And they always give you the cheapest hotels. Beds that everybody done had sex in and did drugs in and everything else. I'm not living like that ever again. No, I rebuke that. I'm going for the highest level. Whatever the highest level is, that's my goal. I already did the grimy stuff. I did the poor stuff. I lived the poor mentality. I did the broke job, the broke life. I'm not doing that bust life no more. The hell with that. I'm living my best life 24/7. That's my mindset. You see what's behind me? Legacy. Legacy guarantees my abundance. Building my legacy guarantees my abundance. I'm not with that bust life, that broke life. I'm not, man, I'm gonna save me a couple dollars and go to this 3-star hotel. That might be okay for you. That ain't for me anymore. If you go out looking for a house and you go look, you get a realtor and the realtor starts taking you around for houses in your price range. I want you to experiment with this. Houses in your price range, you start going looking around at these houses and you're looking at a 3-bedroom, 2-bath house. Let's say that's probably the average house that most people get when they're looking for a house, average. And you're looking at these houses, you look at 4 or 5 of these houses, you're trying to decide which one you're going to get, which one you're going to live in, which one you're going to buy. And then the realtor says, I got this really special house. I just want to show it to you. It's not in your budget, but I just want to show you this house. And then the realtor takes you to like a 5-bedroom, 4-bath house with a lake and a pool. And you walk through that house and your eyes are popping. You're smiling. You're imagining yourself living in that house. But it's out of your budget and you can't get it. And then you got to go back and make a decision on those other little 3-bedroom, 2-bath houses with no pool and no lake view. When you walk back in those other houses, you're going to be like, damn, this is a little tight. It's a little tight in here. It's a little tight in here. Because why? Because your mind was expanded by going to the bigger house. That's why it's dumb for realtors to take somebody to a house not in their price range. Because they mess their buyer's head up and they end up losing deals that way. It's psychology. It's neuroscience. You have to take the person to everything that only fits into their budget. Matter of fact, what I would do if I was a realtor, I would take them to smaller houses that are not in their budget, that are underneath their budget first, below their budget. And then I would amaze them with the house that was in their budget. They'd be like, ooh, ooh, goodness, they just got some space over here. And I really like this a lot better. And now you're going to close the deal. Never take a person to a house that's bigger than what's in their budget. I see people do it all the time. That's dumb. Because the mind's already expanded. My mind's expanded 5-star. And in some cases, 5-star plus. My barber was telling me that I finally got a haircut. I had a haircut in a month. My barber was telling me today that he goes to this phenomenal hotel in Puerto Rico, right? He's Puerto Rican. Good friend of mine for 20 years now. And there's a couple of hotels there that are just phenomenal. One he goes to, it's about $500 a night. And it's beautiful. It got a great view. He showed me everything. Then he showed me, you know, there's a Ritz-Carlton there where all the celebrities go. It's 5-star plus, but it's $2,000 a night. By the way, my mind goes, I want to go to the Ritz-Carlton over there. I want to go to the 5-star plus. My mind instantly goes there. It's not like I'm saying, you know, I'm ignoring him, but I'm going, okay, I think if I went there, I would go to his hotel and just check it out, but I'm going to go 5-star plus. My mind wants to go, my mind wants the best. My mind is seeking the best for itself, for me, for my family, for my own prosperity. My mind's not seeking, how can I save a couple dollars? I have a friend that I have that's rich, not wealthy, but rich. There's a difference between the two. And this friend has the capability of getting airline buddy passes for the airlines to travel. Now, this friend, even though this friend has 8 figures in the bank, access cash, liquid, 8 figures, this friend will actually wait for these buddy passes and sometimes not even be able to make the flight because the buddy passes put you on standby. Right? And I'm going, okay, you mean to tell me you wouldn't spend $300 or $400 for this airline ticket because you wanted to get the buddy pass? Are you kidding me? You just lost out on a deal, on an opportunity over here because you missed this flight. That's a lack of abundance mentality. Now you may say, well, this person's already got a lot of money. Well, they could be, at this moment, they could be a billionaire right now at this moment if they were doing everything right. It's all about when you put a shark in a tank, the shark is only going to grow to the size of that environment, that tank. If you put a shark in a tank that's this big, that shark is going to be a tiny little shark. If you get a bigger tank, that shark's going to grow to the size of the next tank. If you never get a bigger tank, it's never going to grow. If you get a bigger tank, that shark's going to grow to the size of the next bigger tank. It's going to swell up to the size of its environment. If you start trying to discount everything in your life, you're going to literally put a cap on your abundance. Thank you for the badges there, Lucky. Appreciate that. That goes to the kids. You're going to put a cap. You're going to put a cap on your own abundance. That's what you're going to do. You're putting a cap on yourself. My sister is a 4-time world champion bodybuilder. Maria Carson, right? You're going to see her in my workshop, my Manifest Destiny 2022 virtual retreat. She's in my workshop teaching fitness hacks and exercise hacks for people that want to start with their fitness for the new year, right? New Year's resolution time. And she trains professionals. Thank you, King, for the badge. She trains professionals. Not only is she a professional, winner, a champion, but she now trains champions. She's got now a Rolodex full of champions that she's built. She's a champion trainer, a champion coach in bodybuilding. She's coming to work me out. She'll be here December the 11th if she arrives. I'm doing a 60-day challenge with her. She's going to put me on a 60-day challenge. So that by the time Valentine's Day come around, I'm going to be sexy in the physical, right? And so the reason why I bring this up is because thank you, Lucifer, for the badges. The reason why I bring this up is because she has a fee. And she don't charge cheap. My sister charges $10,500 for live-in fitness training, all meals cooked, all supplements, and everything. Supplements, the meals, the exercise, it's all inclusive. I don't have to do nothing but roll out of my bed, train with her, and then every meal that I've got to have for the day, because it's different levels of meals, different times you have to stagger these meals, and you have to have the right meals at the right time and all this stuff. I don't have time to think like that. All I want to do is open my mouth. You put the food in my mouth. That's the kind of service I want. You put the food in my mouth. It's time to take these supplements. You stuff the supplements down my throat. I don't know what to get. Thank you, William, for the badges. She charges $10,500. She says, but you know, you're the brother, man. You're the bro. You always take care of me. I do it for $7,000. I said, no. I said, no. I pay full price. I pay full price. I don't want a discount because I'm your brother. I don't want no damn discounts. I'm paying full price. When you start looking for these deals and these discounts all the damn time, I'm not saying don't try to save yourself some money. But yeah, at some point, you got to come to the abundance mindset. The abundance mindset says everybody has to eat. Thank you for the badges. I can't whip by so fast. The abundance mindset says everybody has to eat. Everybody has to eat. That's the abundance mindset. That's why you work on this, abundance is guaranteed. Guaranteed. I don't want no family discounts. I don't want no friends discounts. Friends, I pay full price. Sometimes I pay more. I pay more. I can go get a haircut for $15. I pay 30. Man, you got to eat, man. But Franco, if I get on the phone, I was in Michigan. Elizabeth Huxter is my witness. I was doing a photo shoot for a new show. And I had been gone for a while. I didn't have a good haircut. I don't know anybody in Michigan. I said, Franco, I need you to come up here and give me a haircut. Franco went and hopped on an airplane, flew to Michigan, gave me a haircut, and flew back home. Everybody has to eat. That's VIP service. Everybody has to eat. He didn't want to charge me a penny for that. I started to stuff the money down in his pocket. He wouldn't take it. You know why he did that? Because I've been taking care of him for 20 years. I've been overpaying, over tipping. You know what I'm saying? All this, I want a discount. My friend got a small business and I want my friend to give me this discount. I can get the hookup over here. All this hookup, the hookup mindset. Throw that shit out the window. No more hookup mindset. That's broke mindset. Hookups and plugs and discounts. That's broke mind. That's the broke mentality. That's the broke mentality. What you're telling the universe is, I don't deserve abundance. I don't believe abundance is happening for me. I don't believe I'm abundant. I don't believe abundance is going to continue. So I need to wiggle my way and save every penny I can because I don't think abundance is going to continue. That's what it means. And you're talking to a guy that was underneath the gutter. And I had that mindset coming up. It ain't like I just start getting like this. I've been teaching this when I was poor. I'm the one who got my mother to make money. My own mother. My mother was broke and poor. My mother was a newspaper delivery woman. That's what my mother was. She delivered the Miami Herald for a living. I don't think you understand how poor that is, but that's pretty damn poor. And she cleaned toilets at the Don Shula Resort in Davie, in Miami Lakes. Don Shula Resort, Miami Lakes. How do I know this? Because I used to have to go there when she was sick or couldn't do it. I used to have to go with my dad and do it and clean the toilets. I would clean the toilets and then go to school. Or when she got burnt in the kitchen and was down for about 3 weeks, I had to go deliver all those newspapers with my dad in Miami Lakes to those condos down there and then go to school. And I was just a kid. I'm talking about grade school level, right? My mother slipped and fell inside of Winn-Dixie. Now, I'm looking at my mom and my dad, and I'm scratching my head, and I'm just a kid. And I'm noticing that they're putting all their money in a shoebox in top of the closet. And I don't know much about nothing, but I knew that didn't make any sense to me. Something was off. My brain just told me, this doesn't seem like it makes any sense. Remember, by this time, I had already read all these encyclopedias on economics. If you don't know my story, you got to check out my story. I started researching aerospace in elementary school in the encyclopedias. This is 1970s. And so I started learning about all of the aerospace. But then along comes the encyclopedia salesman, brings the encyclopedias to my house. And I start reading the encyclopedias on economics and governments. And so now I know about economics and governments from just reading damn books. And I'm watching my parents poorly handle finances. And I knew it didn't make any sense. My mom slipped and fell inside of Winn-Dixie grocery store in Miami. And she bust her knee and she won $5,000. I told my mom, I said, I have a business for you because you got to get out of this situation. She said, what business, son? I said, there is a machine in the Opportunity magazine, which I showed it to her. There's a magazine at the time called Opportunity, Business Opportunity magazine. People advertise their business opportunities, home-based businesses. I said, there's a machine in here called the Von Schrader Foam Extraction, Dry Foam Extraction Machine. Von Schrader Dry Foam Extraction Machine. It does carpet and it does upholstery. And it uses a new dry foam extraction technique to where the carpet dries quickly and it doesn't wet the padding underneath and make it stink. and it dries the furniture. It cleans it really good and dries very quickly because it uses a foam extraction method, not water. It costs $4,999. I said, you need to take that money, that $5,000, and you need to buy this machine. She said, well, how in the hell am I gonna make money with this machine? I said, Mom, you deliver newspapers every single day to rich people. All you have to do is this. Now, this is in the 80s. Carpet was big back then. This is in the 80s. Now we're in the 80s. I'm fast forwarding to the 80s. Carpet was huge back then, right? I said, all you have to do is make a flyer and stuff it in every newspaper that you're delivering to the people that already love you for bringing them a newspaper. Every year, these people give you wine and bonus money and tips for bringing them the newspapers all year. So now you're gonna stuff it with your flyer, with your face on it, so they know it came from you. And these people are gonna call you and book an appointment for you to clean their carpet. They already know you, love you, and trust you. The three most important things in sales. They know you, they love you, and they trust you. The sales, you're gonna close the deal, right? It worked. It worked. My mother started making more money than she ever made in her life. She went from making $15,000 a year to $80,000 a year in the blink of an eye. In the blink of an eye. Off of my financial advice. I've been thinking like this. How did we get out of the ghetto? Well, we moved to a much better neighborhood. There was more mixed neighborhood. The people was more of a middle class. For us, that was like moving to a mansion. I was walking home one day, went to the library in North Miami, and I saw this ballot box for HUD, the HUD home program, where you get $30,000. And what I did was I said, okay, well, this is interesting. If you fill this out and you win it, you get $30,000 to put down on a new home. I told my mom the next day I'm gonna get all the information about dad, and I'm gonna walk home again the next day. 3 mile walk from home from school from North Miami Junior High. Okay, now we're fast forwarding. Now we're in the late 80s now. I think it's like 1986. I go ahead and I go to the library. I fill out these HUD forms. I'm just a kid. I fill all these HUD forms out with my dad's information. Submit it. 3 months later, we get this big manila envelope in the mail. I saw HUD at the top corner. I already knew what it meant. We won. We won the 30 grand to get out of the ghetto. We were almost down damn near. We had to move from one area to another worse area. We were in Liberty City damn near. Off 111th Street in Biscayne, where all the prostitutes and everything were. Right? We won that 30 grand to put down on the house. We ended up moving to Miami, Norland. Got a 3-bedroom, 2-bath house with a pool and a yard. And they put us on Channel 17 News for that. I've been thinking like this. This isn't just, oh, Billy's thinking like this because he made it. No, I've been thinking like this since I was a kid. I had abundance mentality since I was a kid. I took all my toys and went door to door and sold all my toys in the 1970s. All my toys. Everybody was going to the ice cream truck, and I couldn't even afford to go to the ice cream truck. We were eating donated food at the house, and mostly we were eating matzah crackers, which is a Jewish cracker with butter, or we would eat toast and Cairo syrup, which is clear syrup. It's horrible, but when there's nothing else to eat, you put the syrup on your toast. Okay? And so I'm looking at my friends go to this ice cream truck. I'm like, damn, they can go to the ice cream truck every day. I go door to door sell my toys. I'm like, I don't need no damn toys. Sir, ma'am, can I have a donation? A dollar, a penny, a nickel, whatever you can. I'm just trying to get some change for the ice cream truck. I sold all of my toys that day. Boom, gone. Took a picture, a famous picture of me holding my hands up with the money in my hands. I had money to go to the truck and get my bazooka bubble gum so I can get the comic strip and feel like I'm a normal person. But at that moment, something clicked in my head. That was 1978. Something clicked in my head and said, you know what? There's nobody coming to save you. You got to save yourself. Period. If you out here waiting for Jesus and all these people to come down and save you, you're a fool. You're a fool. That's just the reality of it. You got to save yourself. There's nobody coming to save you. You may give yourself the illusion that somebody came and saved you. I see people doing that all day long. What won't he do? He got me this house. You think that there's a man, a male energy God running around saying, this person deserves a house, but this person deserves to be homeless. Come on, guys. This person deserves to win the basketball game and their favorite team deserves to win the game today, but this person, their team don't deserve to win. And this army deserves to win this war over here, but this army, they don't deserve to win. You think there's a God running around doing this kind of foolishness? Come on now. We're trying to bring God into our own small mindset concept of understanding. God is way bigger than that. It's multidimensional, and there is no God running around answering your prayers as to what kind of house you're going to get, what kind of car you're going to get, what kind of war you're going to win. I see people praying all the time, these military people praying to win wars and all kind of crazy foolishness. There's no God running around hoping you're trying to make wave a magic wand so your football team can win a damn football game. So you can cash in on the bet. That's dumb stuff. That's dumb. The only savior that exists is you. The only savior that exists is you. Period. Point blank. And until you wake up and realize that you are your own savior, you're the savior that you've been waiting on. The second coming of Christ is Christ consciousness. Jesus never said he was coming back. He said that Christ would return. Jesus never said he was coming back. He said that Christ would return. That's Christ consciousness. And there have been dozens of Christs long before Jesus even existed. His name was Yeshua. Christ consciousness exists. That's the second coming, when you wake up to a higher level of thinking and go deep within yourself, because the kingdom of heaven is inside of you. Not on the outside, it's on the inside. And until you realize that and realize that you have to save yourself, you're going to be sitting around, woe is me, woe is me. When is it going to be my turn? And all this kind of food. Then you use religion as an excuse for your lack of inspiration. You use a religion for your excuse as your laziness and your procrastination. It wasn't my time. It wasn't your time because you ain't do a damn thing. You sat around following the program code like a good robot. That's why it wasn't your time. You're doing dumb stuff. You're trying to use religion as your scapegoat. Right? That's what you do. It was in God's will. And all this kind of foolishness. Come on, guys. When are we going to get to the next level? Consciousness, man. That's dumb stuff. That's dumb. And I hate to say it. I got to tell you, raw and hard. I'm not going to be soft and sugarcoated. It's dumb. Wake up. Wake up. It's dumb. It's dumb. It sounds dumb. When you say it enough times and think about it, there's a man in space flying around with a magic wand. If you get into a car accident, the religious people go, they pray for the guy. Usually that's the prayer. When they say, I'm going to pray for you, that's usually the prayer. That's the end of the prayer. That's the beginning and the end of the prayer. I'm going to pray for you. Okay, that knows that person's bullshitting me. But the person gets into a car accident, everybody wants to pray for the person. If the person makes it, God healed them. If the person don't make it, it was God's will. No, the guy was in the wrong place at the wrong time, got into an accident and died. That's life. It's life. There's no God running around. This guy deserves to live a little bit longer, but this kid over here, he deserves to get raped in the butt and sold into sex slavery. Come on, guys. Are you guys for real out there? We got to get out of this religious mindset. We got to get out of this broke mindset. We got to get out of doing dumb stuff. We got to start thinking like supreme beings. We got to stop thinking like dummies. That's our biggest problem on this planet, is the IQ deficit. Too many people running around here thinking like dummies. I don't even want to call it thinking, just operating on programming code. I'm being real with you guys. I'm not, you know me, this is forbidden knowledge, man. I'm not going to sugarcoat the stuff, man. I'm going to tell you like it is. We're doing dumb stuff. Me included. We do dumb stuff. I'm not out of the realm of doing dumb stuff. I've done dumb stuff. Me too. I'm included in that list. It's all of us. We have to stop doing dumb stuff. We got to start thinking like supreme beings. And when you start thinking like a supreme, when I changed my mind and start thinking like a supreme being, that's when everything really started clicking for me. Everything's really started clicking for me like this. Manifestations would become instant. Things I'm trying to create become instant. If I speak something, it happens. Because I took my mindset out of the lack and programming code mindset into a supreme being mindset, where it's not that I'm out here creating planets and stuff, but I'm walking with the understanding that the true power and nature of the entire universe is inside of my body. And so God is me and I am God at the same time. Vice versa. So a fractal of that power is being inhabited in this avatar body, and my consciousness is tied directly to the main source of that power. And so because of that, I have power to command my own realities into existence, which is what I do every single day. That's power. And I set myself a bar. Women set a bar for men, right? I know there's a woman who commented earlier about me being wanting to go at five-star hotels only. But that same woman will set a bar for a man. If a man takes you on a date and treats you nice and you guys have a great time and you go on another date and the other guy doesn't treat you as nice, he doesn't open the door for you, he doesn't smile and look you in the eye, you'd be like, man, this other guy was way better than this guy. I'm not going to go on a date with this guy anymore because the other guy set the bar for you already. Well, I set the bar for myself in everything. I set the bar for myself in places that I'm going to lay my head. I got a bar for that. I slept in bummy places already. I'm not doing that ever again. You know what I'm saying? I did that. I went through that phase already. I paid my dues. I'm not doing that ever again. I set my bar for how my lifestyle is going to be. I lived underneath the gutter already. I lived with crackheads and people getting shot in front of my house and bullets in my doggone house. I lived like that already. I'm not going to live like that ever again. I got a bar set for myself. So when you hear somebody's talking about what they are and not going to do when it comes to how they're living, you got to respect that. Pure and simple. Like I set myself goals. I'm not going to be out here, oh, it's okay for me to do this. No, it ain't okay. It's not okay for me to drop that bar, period. Because let me tell you something. A woman ain't going to drop that bar. Same thing with a dude. You meet a woman, right? And you like the way she's vibing and she's really into your conversation. She seems like she's sincerely laughing at your jokes. She seems like she's got her head on right. She doesn't seem like she's gold digging. She seems like she's really trying to also do something with herself. And then you go on another date with another woman. And on that first date, she's already asking you for money. That happened to me before. I went on a date with this one chick. And she was already asking me for $9,000 for a stretch mark removal. I said, let me get the hell out. I started doing the Michael Jackson moonwalking. Moonwalk right on out of there. In 5 seconds, she want $9,000 to get stretch marks removed. Man, guys don't care nothing about no damn stretch marks. That's just the road to glory for us. We know that's the roadmap. We don't care about those. I'm like, I got to get out of here. First date, I get hit over the head for $9,000, I'm out. So the first one set the bar for me already. You know what I'm saying? She was into my information. She liked the knowledge. You know what I'm saying? She had something going on for herself. She's doing her something. She's independent. The other one, you know, she already looking for a handout, right? So what am I to do? I already have the other one set the bar for me already. I'm not going to go back to the one that hit me over the head for $9,000 in the first date. Come on, man. Set bars for yourself, man. Set yourself for yourself. Like, say to yourself, I'm never going to get... Once you pass a certain level, say out loud, I'm never going to get to this level again in my life. I'm never going to let this happen to me ever again. It's not going to happen. I don't care what I got to do. I'm not going down that low again. I guarantee you won't. I guarantee you won't. If you become a student of success, you won't. And then when you pass the next level, set yourself another bar. Okay, I did this. Now I'm going to the next level. I became a millionaire already. My goal is a billionaire. That's my goal, billionaire status. When I see these memes online, click here and type yes if you're going to be your family's next millionaire. I don't click those anymore. I don't click them. I don't tap them anymore. I don't write yes anymore. For what? I already did that. When I follow now billionaire accounts. Accounts that say have billionaire in their name, the account name. I think Billionaire Hustle and these other billionaire accounts. So I follow billionaire accounts now. You know, I still follow some of the millionaire accounts, but just for inspiration. But I follow billionaire accounts. That's my aspiration to become a billionaire. In my wallet, I have a check that's written out to me for $1 billion. And it must be cashed by October 2026. I walk around with that check in my pocket every single day, written out to myself for $1 billion. Okay? I did the millionaire thing already. It's cool. Okay, next. Set yourself goals in your life. Don't be stagnant. Don't be, oh, I'm comfortable now. Oh, this is so good. Because as soon as you do like this, it'd be like, yeah, I can just relax. That's when they come pull the rug from up under you. You better keep striving for the legacy. They come and pull that rug from right up under you. You get comfortable and stay stagnant in one place too long, they snatch the rug. They snatch it. You be like, damn, what happened? I gotta start from zero. I did that before. I'm never starting from zero again. I've been rich and then lost it. Been rich and lost it. Third time, fourth time, I said, nah, I'm staying up here. I'm not going back down again. I know enough now. I understand the money game, the business game. I understand it all now. That's never going to happen again. Don't put all your eggs in one basket, multiple streams of income, the whole works. I became a student. I became a student. When the student is ready, the teacher will appear. Who's the teacher? You are. You're the teacher. When the student is ready, the teacher will appear. When the teacher is ready, the master will appear. That's the order. That is the order. Somebody said, I want a trillion. That's what I'm talking about. My godson today, I had him on the phone. When he gets good grades, I give him $100 on his report card. So I gave him $100, right? We started talking about business and making money. He's only 9 years old. Nine. He says, we started talking about something. I said, yeah, we're going to make sure you're going to be in the Billy Club, the $1 billion club. He's like, I want to be a trillionaire. I said, that's what I'm talking about. It's not about the money. It's about the freedom. Don't get it twisted now. It's not about the money. It's about the freedom. The money is just an energy exchange. It links you to the things you want to acquire. I want to acquire freedom. When I wake up in the morning, thank you, Ed, for the badges. When I wake up in the morning, if I decide to say, you know, today I want to go somewhere. Where do I want to go today? I hop on my doggone travel app and start booking a trip. I don't got to check in with nobody. I don't have to call nobody and see if I can get this time off. I don't got to think far in advance and say, hey, I'm going to need this extra week off. If I time it on this day plus the weekend I was already going to have off, I can get it up to 10 days now. I don't want to do that foolishness. I just want to walk outside, get in my car, hop on a plane, and get out of here. I work on the road, man, wherever I'm at. That's freedom, man. That's what the money's for, is for freedom. I'm buying my freedom. We're all slaves, including me. But if you manipulate the financial matrix the right way, you can obtain a little bit of extra freedom than the average person. I'm just being straight up honest with you. That's really what it is. All right? That's really literally what it is, freedom. All right? Anyway, guys, what's up, Ancient Architect? I've been rambling on here for a while. I don't know how long I've been on this thing. We've been riding out tonight a little bit, but it's all good. Look, I appreciate y'all. I love y'all. Don't take anything I say personal. I'm just trying to teach you something. Sometimes I got to say things a little bit more firm for you to... Because sometimes, you know, you say things too soft and too delicate, the human brain doesn't take it in. Sometimes it doesn't snap for you. It just, yeah, you know, thank you for the badges, guys. So, you know, sometimes the human brain is just a little like, you know, it doesn't respond to, hey guys, you know, you should probably think about looking into, you know, becoming a little bit more successful and setting a higher mark for yourself when it comes to how your lifestyle is. If I'm talking like that, you guys are going to hang up off this live, man. You got to get the hell out of here. This guy talking some crazy stuff. I'm out here telling you like, look, wake up. This is what's going on out here on these streets. And if you keep playing around out here, you're going to get devoured. Okay? And your family is too, for generations. It's time to break these generational curses. It's time to man up, woman up, and everything else up. Consciousness up. And change the narrative. We've been playing their game, their narrative, too long. Their narrative, they gave us the script, man. And we just reading the script line for line like a bad actor. It's time to change that, man. I want a doggone Academy Award. That's what I want. I want a flow. I want to be reading their script. I want my own script. I want to be a producer, the writer, and the actor of my own play. That's what I want, period. And until I get that, I'm going to keep on striving for it. That's where it's at, guys. That's all I'm into. And if you focus on that, I guarantee you, your life is going to change. All right? All right, guys. Peace. I love y'all. I'll catch y'all later. Hi, I'm Billy Carson, researcher, speaker, and best-selling author of The Compendium of the Emerald Tablets and Woke Doesn't Mean Broke. I'm inviting you to join me on ForbiddenKnowledge.tv to enjoy hours of great programming, learn the secrets of ancient Egypt, unexplained structures on the moon and Mars, financial literacy, holistic and healthy lifestyles. Go now to ForbiddenKnowledge.tv and get 3 days free. While there, you can enter to win a Rolls Royce. That's ForbiddenKnowledge.tv. You are watching Forbidden Knowledge TV. Hi, my name is Billy Carson, and I'm the president of Forbidden Knowledge. We have an amazing investment opportunity here for anyone who wants to buy shares in Forbidden Knowledge. The money that's generated from this crowdfunding platform is going to be used to bring on a new content acquisitions partner. We're going to hire a new in-house graphics designer, a social media manager, put together a customer service team and a customer service management program that will organize and satisfy all the different legs of Forbidden Knowledge, Inc., as well as, and of course, make more improved high quality streaming content for the Forbidden Knowledge TV platform, which right now is featured on Apple TV, Roku, Amazon Fire TV, iOS and Android apps, and also, of course, the web. The streaming platform is a year old right now and doing very, very well. And we're looking for your support where you can not only be a conscious customer, but also be a part owner in an amazing opportunity that includes streaming TV, book publishing, and e-commerce. Grow with us and earn with us. Forbidden Knowledge, Inc.